sales skills are some of the most crucial skills on the job. Not only do sales drive revenue inside an organization, which is necessary in the long run, but sales are also important micro skills. They're useful on a daily basis for anyone who wants to get anything done. At Management Consulted, we train organizations to move from level 2 sales to level 3. Let me lay out the levels really quickly for you. First of all, level 1 sales is understanding products and features. This is what we offer. Choose. Level 2 sales training is where somebody recommends a tailored, specific, customized approach. They say, instead of all that we offer, this is what we recommend for you. Level 3 sales training is strategic selling, which focuses on the long-term LTV, lifetime value of a customer. It focuses on, in some situations, doing what is best for the customer in the short term to ensure that a holistic view is taken in the long run. And it creates a stickiness that cannot be achieved with level 1 and level 2 sales. So when we're training organizations to move from level 2 to level 3 sales, there are 3 core skills that we focus on. The first and most critical part of moving from level 2 to level 3 sales is differentiating between product-focused questions, how will you use this, to purpose-focused questions, why does this matter? Getting to the why helps an organization that is selling understand the needs of the organization that they're selling to. If it's a consumer-focused business, one of the pictures that we love is the difference between a drill and a swing set. If you sell someone a drill, the implication is that you need to communicate to them how many holes it drills, what size, and what the durability of the drill is. If you sell them a swing set, which they will create with a drill, you sell them happiness. You sell them the experience of their children. You sell them the work of their hands, not the holes that they're drilling. And the goal of a great level 3 salesperson is to get to what that is. What is the promise or the purpose of an organization and how they're looking to use whatever it is that you're offering or selling? Number 2. Once trust has been established, it's critical that objections are plainly and directly discussed. Many people stay away from really fully understanding the negatives, why someone wouldn't use you, why your product might not work, what the concerns are about the budget, what other priorities are that we're competing for this issue. Because if the negatives aren't discussed, then it comes across as too rosy picture, a promise that's unlikely to live up to expectations. So understanding the objections, acknowledging objections, and really directly asking for them and hearing from them builds tremendous trust in the short and in the long term. But the third and most important thing that we talk about is how to provide a comprehensive program and then strategically remove certain features or items from the program. One of the biggest trust builders is when someone knows that they could take the package, but you're going to give them 60% of the package because that's the right fit for them. The stickiness of doing the right thing for the customer is the biggest factor for success. And when you build their trust in the short run, it always pays off in the long run. In our sales training, for example, we often let people know that if they have onboarding training, our training is not the right thing for them at the beginning. It's a great feature for them to get people familiar with their products and services. And we recommend how they should do that, but that they shouldn't work with us. We become strategic advisors for this kind of transformation, for moving from adequate salespeople to exceptional salespeople. If you're interested in transforming your salespeople from level 2 to level 3 salespeople, from great recommenders to long-term, sticky, strategic advisors, we would love to help. We've helped Fortune 100 all the way down to small boutique firms transform the way that they strategically sell. And our focus is on helping with sales skills training to make the difference in the long run. For a transformative sales training experience, you can find us at managementconsulted.com or you can reach out to us by email. Thanks so much for listening.